was tapping into surveillance systems across Gotham. Any building using Wayne Tech security could be spied on from the CEO's office.
How is that any different than the back door into the Wayne network that he uncovered?
It's not. Unless... Hold on.
Huh. Got a new security tab. And we looked at everything in here. This should end being ghosted as well. Security.
What do we have here? They did more than just look at these schematics. Every building in Gotham with a Wayne Tech security system can be accessed from here and remotely controlled. If Oswald was the brawn, Vicky is the brains. So let's check her file. She may have left clues about what she was using Oswald's access for.
Oh, we're gonna check records again. We can't look at her again. I already looked at her. Well, we're supposed to go back out here, aren't we? I think. To see what's been added? Unlock. Oh, now we can unlock the activity.
Now that we know how Oswald manipulated Vicky's records, the back computer should be able to... There. No more holes.
Sorry, guys. Vicky Vale patient files. Vicky Vale Wayne Tech. Let's see the patient files.
She was looking into Arkham patients. Reviewing records, checking submissions, prior histories. She was trying to figure out who was actually sick and who was committed because of Hill, Falcone, and my father.
Alright. Wayne Tech.
Vicky was digging deep. Gotham City records, freedom of information requests, posts to conspiracy forums. All to find...
It's a list. Gotham buildings that use Wayne Tech security systems.
It's a list of targets.
City Hall, Arkham Asylum, GCPD headquarters, Gotham First National. It's almost every landmark in the city.
We're onto something.
Yeah,
Vicky wants to bypass the security at a Gotham landmark. But without a man inside Wayne Enterprises, she can't unlock that door remotely. She'll have to get her hands dirty. And when she does, we'll find her.
Bruce, you there? It's urgent. One of the bat prototypes has been stolen.
By Lady Arkham?
Is that Lucius?
Not quite. I'm patching you the feed now.
She stole from you?
I stole from her, too.
We opened our doors to her. After all that you two...
Alfred.
Yeah, I know, Bruce, but...
Don't be jealous.
Why would she do this?
She's a thief.
Is she that cold-hearted? That selfish?
She must have a reason.
She must have her reasons.
Well, I'm sure she does.
The device she stole. It's a prototype. It's an electronic skeleton key. With it, you could bypass any security system made by Wayne Tech.
I don't know if I trust her that much.
That key is far too dangerous in Miss Kyle's hands.
Agreed.
Especially with Lady Arkham still at large.
Get the car ready, Alfred. I'm going to get some answers from Selina.
Well, speak of the devil.
Damn it.
Yeah.
Hey, Bruce.
Hands up.
I wasn't expecting you.
You're under arrest.
Thought I'd make it outside the city limits, at least. Clearly my ride needs a tune-up.
Trying to get my attention?
If you wanted to see me, you could have just called.
The chase is so much more fun.
Yeah.
But I know you're not here for me. Are you? I don't blame you for wanting it back.
Neither do I.
It only seems fair that I take something from you.
We did take something from her apartment.
You didn't give a second thought when you stole my claw. At least I had the decency to steal from you when you weren't in the next room.
I wanted a memento of you.
Maybe I just wanted a memento.
Oh, that's good. I'll have to remember that one.
Do we have the claw? Can we trade it back?
I'm surprised you had a toy like this.
Why are you surprised?
No doubt Batman would use it for the good of Gotham. But the less noble options are so much more.
She could steal so much from the
exciting.
City.
Exciting. Why should I give it back?
Because you love me.
So much potential. Just imagine what I'd be able to dig my claws into.
Hand it over.
Enough games, Selina. Hand it over. Now.
You just have no imagination, do you?
Pretty much. I'll give you the claw back.
Catch.
Thought that was going to be a quick time event.
It's clear you're not going to be any fun. And I'm not in the mood for a fight.
I'm more fun when you're naked.
Oh, come on. Don't pretend you're not impressed. As long cons go, this one was a beauty. Getting into Wayne Tech's lab took a lot more than cracking a safe. I had to get close to people. Your friend Harvey. Poor guy just wanted to fall in love so bad. After that, it didn't take very long to get my introduction to his BFF. The great Bruce Wayne.
You really used him all along, Harvey?
Imagine my surprise when the rich playboy turned out to be Batman, scourge of Gotham.
Was it all an act?
I was always going to steal from Bruce Wayne. I just never expected he'd be so interesting.
So it was all just an act. Everything we've done together. A lie.
That's how it started.
Oh?
And now it's over.
Well,
I'm getting out of here while the getting's good. Gotham's a house on fire, and I'm not gonna burn with it. If you were smart, you'd get out of here too. This town hates you, hates your entire family. Just leave it all behind. Do something more meaningful with those skills of yours.
What, should I go to Metropolis?
You don't need the money, but think of the fun.
Gotham needs me.
Gotham needs me. And I won't abandon the people of this city, no matter how they feel about me.
That's right, Lena.
After the way they've treated you, you've got one hell of a thick skin.
Yeah, well,
you're gonna need it.
You ever watch X-Men?
It'd be good to put some distance between us. After all, look at what happened to Harvey. It'd only be a matter of time before I crossed one of your lines. Isn't that right?
Kind of already have,
my
with the key.
My copy of the Boy Scout handbook is out of date. I'm bound to break some rule.
I could never hurt you.
Selina, I would never hurt you.
Bruce, that's really sweet. But it brings us to the root of our problem, doesn't it?
You want me to hurt you.
You're upset that I'm leaving.
Well, kinda.
What'd you think? That one night of sex meant we were going steady? Is that what you really thought?
It meant something to me.
Well, maybe it meant nothing to you, but what happened between us meant something to me.
Well, Bruce, didn't know you were the sensitive type.
Just stop the show, Selina. Stop pretending nothing matters.
Yeah, be real.
Look, Bruce, I'll admit that what you and I had, it wasn't terrible.
It wasn't terrible.
But you
Thanks.
Had just another job. A more intriguing job than I was expecting. But still a job.
The snare.
And that job's done. I'm done with you. It's not complicated. I'm not a good person. I'm certainly no hero, and I don't want to be. I'm a thief. That's all I am.
That's what I said. She's a thief.
I told you that from the start. I never pretended to be anything else.
But, you know, that's not true.
Stop. It's not true. I know there's more to you than that. You're just afraid to admit it.
You'd like it if that were true, wouldn't you?
You are multifaceted.
Why would you even think that?
Why not?
I've made my feelings pretty clear. Why aren't you listening?
You make a good team. I'm not going to say
that. You fought by my side. And together we saved a lot of lives. We're a good team, Selina.
You had to know that wouldn't last.
No, I didn't.
But it was nice. While it did.
Hey, well, your rules, lady.
You know, after I found out you were Batman, I thought nothing else could surprise me. But you just keep on surprising me.
Yeah, full of surprises. Yeah, give her a kissy. Oh god, the noises.
Something to remember me by.
I won't need any help remembering you.
Well, at least I got that.
It's been fun.
Yeah, I get that feeling that's been fun for you, but... see you around?
See you around?
Maybe.
She could just as easily go around our car anyway. Like she did just now.
Lucius, I've got the key. Hold on, Alfred's on the line. Hey, Alfred,
Bruce! Lady Arkham! She's here!
Oops!
I tried to keep them out, but...
Uh-oh.
Alfred? Alfred!
Does it have to do with us putting our computer back online?
Alfred!
Because that's why we turned it off, so they wouldn't find the Batcave. Okay, they've ransacked the place. Thanks.
Lucius, it's Bruce.
The second time
He's
this game.
He's not here. Damn it.
Oh.
I'm going to search for clues.
Someone's playing Bloody
Just
Pool.
Tell me how I can help.
Get over here as fast as you can.
I'm on my way. We're gonna find him, Bruce.
Who's in that room? Someone's in his room staring
Need to
at
focus.
His butt.
Figure out what happened here. What happened to you, Al?
Al. Alright, let me restart the recording. Alright, we got stuff to look at. We got lots of scuff marks. And stuff.
A scuff mark. What could have caused this?
For anyone just tuning in, I'm getting over a cold. My voice does not normally sound like this. It just does now, and it's annoying, but what can I do? Look at furniture. My apologies anyway.
Furniture scattered outwards from a single point.
Fireplace.
Ash everywhere.
The ash and coal strewn fireplace. Mantle blood. Blood from a mantle.
What did they do to you, Alfred?
Broken shelf. What did they do to you, shelf? My god. You used to hold all my books so expertly, and now look at you.
Something big was thrown against this wall. Or someone.
Hopefully not an Alfred. Broad crack in the wall. Well, I don't think you could link those two together. Can I move this way? There's gotta be more stuff to look at. Busted vase. Well, whatever was in the vase could have been resulted in very heavy. Wasn't his, well, it says vase, not urn. Otherwise, I think it's his parents' ashes. That'd be great, wouldn't it?
Face was knocked over in the struggle.
Alright, knocked
Fight
over.
Fight left nothing untouched.
Not thrown. Let's see what else we got. We got some bloody pool over here. Bloody billiards. Well, I can also link the scuff mark. Could be the ashes from the fireplace.
See a connection here.
Hmm. Oh well. Fire poker? That's very high up. Oh, it's thrown into that wall
the
there.
Hell?
A metal fire. That must have been thrown with some force, let me tell you. Well, we know it probably came from the fireplace. Is that because his tech's not working right?
Alfred grabbed the fireplace poker to fend off an attacker.
Oh, he's knocked away. Flung it over him like that. Okay. Very good, my dear boy. Broken lock.
The lock's been completely destroyed. Alfred must have barricaded himself in here. But they got in anyway.
Yep. Because that door is ajar. Blood splatter.
Blood pattern looks like it came off a high velocity hit.
Could be whatever stone hit here and bounced into there, but I'm not sure. Let's look around for more stuff. Pool cue.
This pool cue was used as a weapon.
It broke.
Swung so hard it broke in half.
Splashes of blood, broken, bloodied end of a pool cue.
Alfred used the pool cue as a weapon. Broke it across his attacker's head.
Oh, nice,
when
Alfred.
That didn't stop him. He used the jagged end to stab him, spraying blood across the pool table.
Cool. I knew I liked that guy. Now I just gotta link that. Which... scuff mark. Broad crack in the wall. Did I try linking these together? How can we can't go any further this way. Can we go this way here? No, there's nothing else to look at, right? Unless we're looking... These have to link together then, unless there's something I'm missing. Something else. Link it here. And educate us.
Lady Arkham must have used the concussion blast from her staff to try and stop Alfred.
Oh, okay.
I know what happened. The children of Arkham broke in. Alfred barricaded himself inside the parlor.
They
he had just
him.
Enough time to grab a pool cue as a weapon before Lady Arkham blasted the doors open. He broke it across one of their heads, then stabbed him to get away.
That's awesome. Put up quite
Another
a fight.
Another assailant tackled Alfred, knocking over the vase. Alfred almost escaped, but then Lady Arkham entered the parlor. Used her staff's concussion blast, scattering all the furniture in her path, throwing him against the wall by the fireplace.
Ow.
So Alfred grabs the nearest thing to use as a weapon to defend himself.
Cool.
But Lady Arkham deflected Alfred's attack, causing the poker to fly across the room and lodge into the wall. More blood on the mantle.
I had no idea he was so good at
he
fighting.
Smashed his face into it.
Ooh.
Wait. That picture doesn't belong there.
Oh. You know, it'd be interesting, too, if they smashed his face and then we saw, like, little bits of glass from his glasses on the floor, and that would be a hint as well, or a clue.
Lady Arkham wanted me to find this.
Right. She's betting on our detective skills that we'd find out where Alfred was hurt, and she'd put it right near where he was hurt. So is there a clue on this? What we got here?
The butler did it.
The butler did it.
Password reckoning.
Huh.
You have no idea.
What is she, the Riddler now? That's all we're missing is the Riddler, right?
Bruce Wayne, you should be rotting in a padded cell.
Yeah, well, I
now,
love you too.
Your butler, the man who raised you like his own son, will suffer in your place. But don't worry, you'll get him back eventually. Peace, my bloody peace.
Alfred.
Lucius.
Oh,
ow.
God.
Vicky will pay for this.
Vicky will pay for this. I'll make sure of that.
Look at what she's doing to him.
All right. Well, then let's get to work.
That too. That's the other thing, choice of me to say.
Alfred keeps adjusting his glasses. The reflection. He's making sure I see the reflection in his glasses.
A clue of his surroundings?
He knows the back computer can use multiple reflection angles to recreate the room that he's in.
Oh, so smart.
And I can view the virtual image using my cowl.
Good thinking, Alfred.
Use the bat cowl to virtually investigate Alfred's surroundings. Can we use the Gotham feed yet?
Damn it. Nope. Can't access the news feed.
Oh, yeah.
I need to get this working again.
Codec's not working.
Damn it. Still offline. I need to get this working again.
I was trying to skip the dialogue. Alright, so we can use the cowl here. Alright, quick restart. And go.
Okay, Lucius. Freeze frame on the first signal Alfred gives.
Freeze frame!
Paint us a picture.
Freeze frame!
Here we go.
Looking for clues. Child of Arkham. Camera. Stairs. Uplink established.
He's wounded.
Must be one of the thugs Alfred fought upstairs.
Right. Camera.
Professional grade camera. Probably came from the Gazette's office.
Yeah, true. Stairs?
Stairs leading up. Cement walls. We're in a basement.
Right.
Alfred's trying to look at things that might give us a clue to where he's being held. Okay, looks like we've seen all there is to see in this frame. Let's move on to Alfred's next signal.
You got it.
Alfred is awesome. Gotta say. Kicking butt. Now he's being all smart and stuff. Got a water heater. Rogers something.
Rogers Plumbing. A service company for the water heater. I can use their records to find home addresses for their clients.
How many of them will there be?
Yeah, but we're not there yet.
Container must be placed on level surface, blah, blah, blah. Well, hopefully you can cross-reference with their customer database with something else that we'll find, like maybe what's in these boxes.
Doesn't seem to be anything else here.
Let's keep looking.
Nothing else to see here.
Moving on.
You know, we could see that before. Lady Arkham.
Lady Arkham. Keep searching.
Yep. Mason's stamp? Oh, really? They leave little marks of the work they did?
A Mason stamp.
Only one Masonic lodge in the city. Gotham City Fraternal Order of Stonemasons.
Uh-huh.
So the house was built in 1945 by them.
Cool.
That's a big lead.
It is.
Jump to Alfred's next signal.
You got it.
So we could cross-reference the Rogers thing with the Masons' records. Now we just have to access all these records. Window. All we got is a window. He's going back upstairs, this guy. Yeah, window.
The basement window.
What's that outside?
Give me a second.
Zoom in.
They're by a bus stop.
There we go.
Okay, I think we have enough to pinpoint a location.
Yes.
Well, let's hope.
So we can access these repair logs. I guess we're just hacking into their computers using our computer. I mean, I thought we would call them the Rogers people. Whoever's Rogers heating. Kind of interested. Yeah. Repair logs.
These are all the homes serviced by this water heater company on the days and months listed.
Right. Yeah, it's pretty quickly they were able to access all this stuff. Build year.
Okay, filtering for all homes built on that date.
Bus stops.
You can get the bus line from this. But no stop number. This will help pinpoint the neighborhood.
And which of them have basements? Hopefully just one. Oh, three. Location data.
A corner store. seems unlikely. Bowling alley. Damn it. Let's keep looking.
Bet you no matter what I chose, the last one would always be the real location.
You are not going to believe this.
What is it?
Better believe it,
baby. Lady Arkham is back at the Vale House, where she killed her foster parents. According to its records, it has a basement.
That's a stupid place for her to do it.
But I'm without a working batsuit.
Actually.
Doesn't she know that we were there?
It has basic cowl functionality, but outside of that, it doesn't protect much more than your identity, I'm afraid.
Now, that's silly of her. That is really silly, because without any information, just randomly, like if we couldn't see reflections using the cowl, I'd just be like, okay, well, I don't know where the hell she is. Let's go back to, you know, her house where we found Robin. Oh, that has nothing to do with anything. And, yeah, it's just, she has a clear motive for going back there. Killers often return to the scene of the crime, so she would know that, right? Unless she wants us to go after us and find her. And make us think that, yeah, she's dumb. Let's go get her. You know, so, yeah. She might be completely manipulating us that way. Who the hell knows, but let's put on the batsuit.
Good call. Thank you, Lucius.
Good call.
It doesn't have all the bells and whistles, but it should still scare the crap out of criminals.
Be the old 1940s Batman edition.
This ends tonight.
Oh, yeah. He looked like Rex from Mass Effect the way he did that. Or, is that Rex? I think it was Grunt, actually. Who did that? Back to the Vale Residence, 8:38 p.m. We never went up or down any stairs. We just looked in a stair, you know, kind of...
Heading into the basement.
Be careful.
In a little compartment under the stairs. Oh, we found, Harry Potter, I meant, Robin. Advancing down. I pressed E, damn it. It's not quickly enough. Now I see the line. My voice sounds horrible,
heading
I'm sorry,
the basement.
Guys.
Be careful.
I can't just choose to step over this. Well, let's press E right away. I know it's there now, I just have to walk forward into it anyway.
Batman!
I'm alright.
That's funny. I sensed a premonition of my demise in another universe, multiverse, whatever.
There's no one here. No Alfred.
It was Earth-Z.
There's blood on the walls.
That Batman died at that point.
I'm going to see what I can find.
Standing by.
We're gonna see what we can find, tough boys. No. Shut up. Blood trail. Oh, yeah. With a boot print.
There's a boot print in the blood.
One of the children of Arkham.
Soldiers dragged him. The trail stops at the wall. Actually, it goes under it.
Is that Alfred's boot print?
Sounds like there's more to this basement than it would appear.
Mm-hmm. Taking a closer look.
Well, first, let's look at this other stuff. I don't want to miss looking at everything. Because once we hit that, there's a good chance we'll just, you know, end up going that way.
This is where they had Alfred. Where they beat him.
Oh god, it's just a chair. Don't get dramatic about it. I'm more alarmed about the blood than anything else.
The blood hasn't congealed yet.
Means we can't be far behind them.
No, I mean, blood congeals pretty quickly. Super heavy, man! You put that super there to goad me in, didn't you? Because I always afraid that I'm not as good as Superman. And she wants to prey on that fear. Alright. Look at... Before kick or push.
The wall is just a facade.
Why would the Vales have a false wall in their basement?
To hide something. Within it is a steamroller of doom. Let's push. Push probably won't work. Probably have to kick it. But I just want to see what happens with push.
Now let's find out what the Vales were hiding.
Oh, push did work. Look at that. Chemical?
There's a small room.
Oh. An underground facility.
With a hole in the floor.
Why put this all in her childhood home? You could rent any place and mess with this. Oh yeah, call out. Yeah, we're definitely gonna call out. Let's just look at the rope ladder.
A rope ladder.
Yep.
Anyone down there would be trapped.
Unless they can jump really high or stand on something. Pull. I'm not calling out. It's stupid. Oh, there is a thingy. A power cable? Enter the hole. Sounds suggestive. Enter the hole. Oh yeah, he's going in. Oh, it is really far down.